Hello everyone, welcome to Blue Cube channel. In this video, I will teach you how to move and track the camera in After Effects. Exactly like the video you are watching now. You can also add text, logo or images to the video. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, I recommend that you subscribe so that you can see the next tutorials. I have a video in the timeline that I want to shorten the extra parts of. So I put the time indicator here and hit the Alt plus left bracket keys. I also shorten the end of the video with the Alt plus right bracket keys. Now I place the layer bar at the beginning of the timeline. I right-click on the layer and create a pre-compose called V1. Now I type the name of my channel with the typing tool. You can type any name. I choose a color for the text. To place the anchor point in the middle of the text, I hold the Ctrl key and double-click the pan behind tool. I even make the text layer 3D. Note that the renderer must be set to Cinema 4D, so that you can create thickness for the text. You can also change the renderer to Cinema 4D from the composition menu. I will turn off the text layer for now. Now I select the video layer and search for the camera in the effects panel. I apply the 3D camera tracker effect to the video layer, and immediately our video analysis begins. This process may take a few seconds to a few minutes, depending on the power of your system and the length of your video. After doing that, colored dots will be shown on the video, and the dots will stay in place as the video plays. As a result, we can place the text on these points without moving. We can also change the size of the tracking points. By moving the mouse over these points, a red target is created, and each target shows 3 points that help us find a suitable and smooth place. After finding the right place, I click and 3 points will be highlighted. Now I will right-click in this place and select Create Solid and Camera. In this way, a solid and a camera are created. I turn on the text layer. Now I want to link the text layer to the solid, so that the text with the solid stays fixed in this place. Be sure to hold the Shift button and then link the text to the solid. In this way, the text is placed on the solid. I turn off the solid layer so we can see the text. Now we can see that the text stays in place when playing the video. I open the text layer and in the geometry options section, I increase the extrusion depth value to increase the thickness of the text. Now I click on the solid layer and hit the R key to reveal the rotation parameters. By changing the rotation values, I adjust the text. After setting the text, I press the P key to reveal the position parameters. Now we have to adjust the position parameters so that the camera passes through the letter B. I move the time indicator a little forward and move the text a little higher. In this way, you have to play a little with the position parameters, so that the camera is in front of the letter B. I move the time indicator forward again and adjust the position of the solid. Note that since we link the text layer to the solid, by changing the parameters of the solid position, the text will also change. It is appropriate here. In this way, the camera passes between the letter B. Now it's time to create a light source, so I will right-click in this empty space and select light. I choose white color for light. I also select the light point source and click. You can see that the light source is created, but we need to adjust it. For this, I choose two views. In the top view, we can see the text and light layer, so I change the location of the light source in the Z-axis, so that it is in front of the text. I also adjust the light source on the Y-axis. We can see that the color of the text also changes to white with the radiation of light. I double-click on the light layer and decrease the intensity value of the light source. I increase the intensity of the light a little again. Now I open the text layer and the material options section. I adjust the ambient value to achieve the desired color. I select the light source and move it slightly higher and back. After adjusting the light, I close the text layer and advance the time indicator. I go back to the project panel and place the second video on top of the previous one. Now I select the pen tool and create a mask by creating 4 points. I move the time indicator, you can see that the location of the mask changes. So I move the video layer bar forward. It is appropriate here. I open the video layer, then the mask, and click on the stopwatch next to the mask path to create a keyframe. Pay attention that after creating the keyframe, you must click on the video layer so that we can change the location of the mask points. I advance the time indicator, and here we see that the mask is not in the right place. So I adjust the points. After setting the points, a new keyframe is created. I move the time indicator forward again and correct the location of the points. I repeat this several times so that the camera passes between the letter B. Finally, the camera enters this new video. Now I close the layers and go back to one view. I press the space button to play the video, so that the video inside the text does not appear suddenly. I put the time indicator at the beginning of the video and press the letter T to reveal opacity. I click on the stopwatch next to opacity to create a keyframe and set the opacity value to 0. Now I move the time indicator a little further and set the opacity value to 100. In this way, as the camera approaches the text, the video will gradually appear. I put the time indicator on the 15th second and press the letter N to shorten the work area. I press the space button to play the video. We can see that the camera passes well between the letter B and enters the new video. Now I want to create a shadow for the text. So I select all the layers and right-click on one of the layers and create a precompose. Now, in order to be able to create the shadow, we must select the classic 3D renderer from the composition menu and composition setting. I double-click on the pre-compose layer, you can see that Cinema 4D is active inside this composition. Now I select the text and camera layers and copy them by pressing Ctrl plus C. I go back to the previous composition and hit Ctrl plus V to paste. Here you can see that the classic 3D renderer is active. I click on the text layer and change its color to black. I move the text down and hit the letter R to activate the rotation. I rotate the text and move it slightly to the left. In the transform section, I reduce the opacity of the layer. Now I apply the fast backs blur effect to the text layer and increase the blur radius value to create a shadow mode. Finally, I slightly increase the opacity of the layer. I press the space button to see the final result. Well guys, thank you so much for watching this tutorial till the end. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. See you next time.